Let's go to Mt Ruapehu now, where things are getting a little steamy. A steam plume was spotted yesterday above the crater lake, but it's been confirmed that no seismic activity accompanied the plume's appearance, indicating it wasn't generated by strong activity in the lake. But is it something that we should be concerned about? Well, let's bring in volcanologist Geoff Kilgour to hopefully answer that question for me. Morena, Geoff, thank you so much for joining us so early this morning. What's happening at Mt Ruapehu? What's up with the steam plume yesterday?
Good morning, Jenny, mate. Well, not a lot, to be honest. this is another example of the volcano showing signs of unrest. When the lake is warm and there's cold, still air around the volcano, especially the top of the volcano, we sometimes see these plumes being generated, and they look like they're being driven by intense processes at the vent. But really, it's a lot of warm air that's rising and then forming into a plume. But we have seen this in the past, especially when the lake is around 40 degrees. And at the moment, it's around 39 degrees. So it's getting upwards of what we would expect to be seeing some of these steam plumes.
All right. So, I mean, you don't seem to be too concerned about this, but I don't know, should we?
Well, we were concerned enough that we sent a plane up with a couple of our scientists to do an observation flight to make sure that we hadn't missed anything that was a little bit more local to the lake. So when we started seeing this plume, we looked through all of our seismic network and all of our acoustic data to see if any small explosions had occurred. And we could clearly see that nothing of that nature had occurred, which is why we say that there's been no strong activity in the lake. It doesn't mean that we haven't missed very minor activity, but it still means that we're watching this very, very closely, as you can imagine.
Yeah, and you know, the question that is on everybody's lips is about whether Ruapehu will erupt. So we know its history in terms of it has erupted a number of times over the past, 160 years or so. So history tells us that there is real potential for this to happen. I mean, yeah, can we predict that?
So we're not in the predicting business, we're in the forecasting business. It's a bit like the weather service, so Met Service, right? So we see eruptions very, very rarely. Mm. And the Met Service see weather every day. And still we're in this, we can't predict everything that's happening from day to day. But what we can say is that the volcano is clearly heating up, the unrest is building, the tremor that we talked about last time is still on the up slightly. So we're still in this very, very heightened unrest. And so while we're not predicting when it's going to erupt, we're still saying it's much more likely to erupt than it was, let's say, a few months ago.
Yeah, slap on the hand, Jay. May never mention the word predict when we're talking about volcanoes. So in terms of monitoring, what's actually happening at the moment?
So pretty much the same. The one thing that the other set of data that we have now is that we did a gas flight late last week. And what we're looking for there is clear signs that there's magma driving this unrest. So if you recall a few weeks ago, we hadn't really seen any clear magmatic gases driving this unrest. Basically, it means that magma's rising a little bit shallower underneath the crater lake. And as it does that, it releases some of the gas that's dissolved within it. And some of those gases are more indicative of magma getting quite shallow. And so what we saw last week is one of the highest sulfur dioxide peaks or gas emissions that we've seen. And that's basically in the last about 20-odd years, it's the sixth highest value that we've seen. So all of this together indicates to us that magma's really pushing its way towards the crater lake. And so we're expecting to see, if this continues on, that we'll start to see some changes in the chemistry of the lake. We'll start to see a little bit more temperature rising in the lake, and we might see more of this sulfur dioxide present within the gas emissions.
Which brings me to my final question. In terms of volcanic alert levels, Ruapehu is currently sitting in 2. What then would push it into level 3?
Right, so we operate a fairly simple volcanic alert level system. So 0, nothing's happening, 1, minor unrest, level 2 is moderate to heightened unrest. The next levels up are basically the size of the eruption that's occurring at the time. So if we see a very, very small eruption, it might happen 1 minute and then be gone the next, we would call that alert level 3, which is a minor eruption just affecting the area around the summit. As we get up and the impacts and the ash is dispersed much further apart, further away from the volcano, that's when we move into alert level 4 and then 5. Mm-hmm. So at the moment, we won't be moving for some time out of volcanic alert level 2 unless something significant changes. Yeah, and it's really our indication, and we're saying that we're in heightened unrest here, and so this is our indication of our concern for the activity of the volcano.
Geoff Kilgour, as always, it is a pleasure having you with us, and thank you again for joining us so early this morning. Really appreciate it. Geoff Kilgour, volcanologist, joining us from Taupo this morning.